Katie Rice, the style expert, is joining us now, and today she's going to help us get the perfect pair of sunglasses for our face.
Mm. And the biggest thing, Katie, is that people a lot of times don't even realize what the shape of their face is, so they're running around and they're wearing the wrong sunglasses.
That's right. And so once you do know your shape, you can really pick out a beautiful pair of sunglasses that's going to counterbalance your face.
So what's the easiest way to try to figure out what shape you are?
Well, I think the best way is to take a picture just straight on of your face with your camera phone. That's really easy. And take a look at it, because many pictures we see of ourselves are never straight on. Mm-hmm. And the straight on really gives you the dimensions of your face.
Take like a mugshot picture of
yourself. A mugshot, basically. Yeah. Maybe you can use it at a later date for something else, but you know. But in any case, we're talking about sunglasses here. And there are actually, I'd say, five common face shapes. So they are oval, round, oblong, heart, and square. And there goes one of our sunglasses.
So the oval shape is kind of, the oval shape, for example, would be somebody like an Angelina Jolie mm-hmm. or Jessica Simpson, Matthew McConaughey.
Right.
And oval, if you're going to be any shape, you should hope that you're an oval.
You're hoping you're an oval because that's the perfectly balanced shape. And if you think about it, most beautiful people in the world have oval shapes, and it's because they have the symmetry of their face. It's balanced. So oval-shaped people can really wear any sunglass they want. They just have to make sure that the sunglass is in proportion to their face, so not a really small sunglass for a big face and vice versa.
Okay, well, we don't like those people. Let's talk
we
about
don't like
real
those
people like the round-faced people, and the celebrities in the round-faced category would include Kirsten Dunst or Donald Trump.
That's right. Uh-huh.
Huh.
Yeah,
okay.
With the hair.
You just can't get past that.
Yeah, so a round-faced individual is someone whose face is wide as it is as long.
Okay.
Okay.
So like a round-faced person wouldn't want to wear these ones that I've been wearing because those are probably a little too roundy.
A little too oblongy, okay. Roundy, yes. So basically a round-faced person and all the other face shapes we're going to talk about, you want to counterbalance your face. So what we have here for the round is just two pretty squarish sunglasses, not squarish as far mm-hmm. as not cool, but squarish shaped sunglasses, and also a rectangular shape would work well too. So this is for women and this is for men.
So you just want a little something with an edge.
You want something with an edge, yeah, because you want to really give your face more of an angular feel rather than a soft round feel.
Okay.
Okay.
Oblong.
Okay. We have, is it Sarah Jessica Parker,
yep.
Right, and Kevin Federline. They have oblong-shaped faces. Now, an oblong-shaped face is one that is longer than it is wide. And so what we want to do with sunglasses right here is we want to do a wide, deep glass. What that's going to do for their face, again, is going to counterbalance it, make it look more oval by giving them a wide, deep sunglass. And this is for women, and then this would be for men.
Those almost look like wraparounds right there.
Yeah. They do. But, I mean, it can be this style or many other styles, mm-hmm. but they just want to make sure that they are sort of going across their face and ending off their face and their deep sunglasses.
Okay, heart-shaped is what you guessed I was probably closest to. And
yes.
The celebs that my face most resembles, apparently, at least shape-wise, Reese Witherspoon and Patrick Dempsey.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. And so heart-shaped individual, such as yourself, has a broader forehead and more of a narrow jawline. Okay. And so you want sunglasses that are more rounded. We don't want any peaks, any sharp corners. We want rounded, and also sunglasses that can be a little fuller at the bottom mm-hmm. than they are at the top, basically
these
the counterbalancing.
Ones, these are the ones you pick for me, and I got to be honest, I like them, but mm-hmm. I never would have picked those
See,
up.
See, isn't that interesting?
It is. Yeah, I never would have picked those up.
Would you have guessed your face shape? Before.
Yeah, I've been told that before. I might have
okay.
guessed that. Yeah.
Okay. And, you know, sometimes your personal style doesn't jive necessarily with what your face shape is telling
with
you to
reality.
Do. Right. And that's why you need to step out of the box.
Join
right.
reality.
Yeah, and pick another, you know, another sunglass that might work better for you. You never know.
And the final shape is square.
It's square. And you and I are both square.
Okay.
I'm sure you've heard that
Thanks
before.
Thanks for that.
And Brooke Shields is square.
Oh, you like her.
I do.
Yeah.
I think she's one beautiful person.
And Simon Cowell, he's very
his
square.
His hair is more square than his face.
I know. Well, he just accentuates the face
yeah.
shape with the hair. I mean, if he wants to make his face look less square, get rid of that do. All right. So anyway, these are the two sunglasses for square. Again, we're just looking for more of a rounded sunglass for a square because a square face has a very angular face. We just want to soften it and make it look a little bit more rounded. And here we are
so you and
as
I
Bobsy
are aviators.
Twins.
Yeah,
I like
talk
it.
To me, Goose.
Uh-huh, yeah. Uh-huh.
All right, Ghost Rider.
Okay, I have one final question.
Okay, yeah.
How do you explain the Olsen twins? Like, what's up? They've got, you know what
yeah,
I'm saying?
Okay, satellite
first
dishes.
Of all, do we have 20 minutes? I mean, how do I explain
the web?
The
sure.
no, you... their sunglasses are completely out of proportion with their faces. And they look like little old grandmas, because it's like you have your grandma's huge sunglasses on and your grandma's big bag. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's the problem. You really have to look at proportion. So if you have a small face, you don't want a very large sunglass. Although it's very trendy to have large sunglasses, but you have to weigh this. I mean, I think if you wear fashion for fashion's sake, you become a fashion victim.
I think when you get cash like that, though, nobody cares.
Yeah, that's probably true.
Yeah.
Now, when you see these pictures, do you say, nah, that's not right, yes, that's right?
Yeah, you tend to do that when you're a style expert.
Okay, mm-hmm. Very good. Thanks for joining us today.
Style expert, thank you very much.
Absolutely.